The story of the SS Mendi is a sad but a rich African history of the 20th century, as it documents a history of black South African men who died facing their death in the frigid waters of the English Channel. Now, the ship was on its way to France in February 1917 during the First World War when it got lost off the south coast of the Isle of Wight with 600 troops on board. And one of those unsung heroes was Isaac Williams Dioba Wachop, whose roots are in Fort Beaufort in the Eastern Cape, and was one of the SS Mendi victims. He was a teacher, he was an interpreter, an author, and a pastor. Now, diver Martin Woodward is recorded as the first person to find and identify the wreck of the SS Mendi in 1974 while investigating various wrecks a few miles south of St. Catherine's Point. And he now joins me with Natalia Sfuba, Wachop's fifth generation granddaughter. And the two met for the very first time during last year's commemoration of the centenary of the Mendi. A very good morning to you two. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning. Good morning. Thank you.
Natalia, I'm going to start with you. You traveled to the UK to attend the centenary. How was that experience for you?
The experience was quite extraordinary. At the same time, it was overwhelming because my mother, Joyce Kalauto, was the one who had kept the story of the Mendi alive for many years. So, and sadly, she passed away in 2015, and she was looking forward to the centenary.
Okay.
Now that she had gone, I had to come in and take over. Mm. As a result, I had to go and represent the Wokop family in the UK.
Since you didn't know your great-grandfather, the sentiments that you've been getting, were they on a more personal or on a historical level, or is it a matter of both?
It's actually both.
Is it?
Let me start with the personal side. On the personal level, it was quite a revelation for the family, because we are told that as soon as the Mendi sank, his son, his only son, he passed the name Isaac to him as well.
Okay.
But the family knows him as Basi. He had then decided to uproot the whole family from Fort Beaufort because of the excruciating pain that the family had endured. He then uprooted the family and came to Johannesburg, to North Mines in particular. This is where that is a story that my maternal grandfather Gingi tells us, that this is how they ended up in Gauteng. And in the late 50s, they then once his contract was over in the mines, he then came with all his family to Soweto in Dlamini.
Really?
So that is the personal part. But on the historic part, I think it's also important to look back as to how relevant and the contribution that my great-grandfather did. He was part of those men that had fought with the colonizers, challenged the colonizers right from the 1600s. Came the Mendi. It came against the backdrop of the Native Land Act of 1913. So they had gone. The story of the Mendi is actually a story of black men who had then wanted to contribute to the war effort, with the view that when they come back home after the war, they will be given a space, they will be given freedoms, for an example.
Yeah.
But sadly, as we know today, that did not happen. So historically, it's something that we have to look back and take that into consideration.
Sure. Now, Martin, 57 years on, and how in the world did you identify the wreck of the SS Mendi? And how did you know for sure that it was indeed the SS Mendi?
Yeah, the wreck was not what was reported as being in that area. There was supposed to be a small barge in the area, and I was investigating lots of wrecks in the English Channel at the time. I found this wreck, and immediately I knew, even though the visibility was bad, that it was quite a big, a good quality ship. Now, after a few dives, I found a little saucer, a little porcelain saucer, blue and white, with the ship's crest on it, which had BNASNC, which meant British and African Steam Navigation Company. And then by a process of elimination, I went home and went through the records and found that it could only be the Mendi. And obviously, you know, when you identify a ship underwater, you count all the boilers and everything fitted into place, and subsequent dives proved beyond doubt that it was the Mendi.
What was your initial reaction when you stumbled upon it?
Initial reaction.
Were you elated or were you.
When I found out the story, it's a strange one because I'd researched all the wrecks in that area and yet the Mendi never flagged up. It was almost like a hidden wreck that was not recorded anywhere. So obviously I was dumbstruck when I unraveled this story, which was such tragedy for South Africa and the people of South Africa. And it numbed me, really, because how can 646 people die off the shores of the island that I live on and no one know about it? So we were all absolutely bowled over by this information.
And as you're now in South Africa, and your name, of course, is written in the history of the SS Mendi, how does that feel? How does it make you feel being associated with such a rich history?
It makes me feel very proud and very privileged because the Mendi is such a poignant story and such a legend of South Africa that I feel very, really pleased to be part of it. I was supposed to have come down here in 1995, but unfortunately that didn't happen. And I'm delighted to come down and have the opportunity now to visit Natalia and meet her again, and also to visit Soweto and bring a little bit of completion to the story from my part, because the Mendi will always be the most significant wreck that I ever found in my career, and I found a lot of shipwrecks in my time.
Yeah. Now, Natalia, to so many people whose relatives lost their life in this tragedy, to them it is just the country's history with absolutely no personal connotations to that particular tragedy. Do you feel honored to having been a part of it?
Definitely. I did feel honored, and also representing the family, because once the Mendi sank, there was no recognition whatsoever by the previous oppressive regime. As a result, come the centenary and post 94, this democratic government has taken a conscious decision to formally honor the Mendi men, because really the previous government wanted to obliterate this history,
yes,
for an example. But unfortunately they failed, because even within black communities, the story of the Mendi was kept alive to such an extent that even in schools, children were reciting the poem by S.E.K. Mqhayi, Ukuchona ka Mendi. So the communities, because those men that died, it was the fathers, the sons, the uncles, you know, members of the community. So they kept the story, you know, alive. So it was really an honor, you know, I can't even describe how I felt about having taken part.
Sure. Well, thank you so much to you two for having shared that piece of history with us on the program. We really are honored to have you on board.
Thank you for having us.
All right, that was Natalia Sifuba. She is the great-granddaughter of Isaac Williams, who's one of the soldiers who perished in the SS Mendi tragedy. And with her was Martin Woodward, who was one of the divers who actually discovered the wreck of the SS Mendi on the English Channel. We thank both of them for sharing that history with us.